The streets still closed out here as they have about 100 police officers. St. Bernard Avenue from Abundance to I-610 and Gentilly Boulevard from Paris to, I believe, Serentine Street is closed down. A lot of people not being allowed in this area. If they do live in this area, they're not being allowed to come back in this area because police are using the motto, if you will, better safe than sorry. Here comes Superintendent Surpass right now to give us an update on where things stand. Chief, if you could tell us where things stand, how did the search go in the school?
Okay, first thing is that we've done a complete 100% search of the building by eyes of our TAC unit, and we find nothing. We are currently having a canine go through the building to make double sure. What we know is at 2:47 p.m. this afternoon at Lafayette in Hamburg, a suspicious person with a gun call came into the police department. Four officers responded. They encountered four people that fit the description. As they encountered these four young men, the young men began to run towards under the I-610, the tracks. One of them turned and fired two shots at the police officers. Our police officers did not return fire. As they were chasing the four men, two of them went over the fence at the back of the school. We captured them. One of them we captured before he went over the fence. We also recovered a Glock 9mm firearm from the scene. A fourth person could not be located, and the officers wisely decided to go to the principal and lock the school down and put into place what we call our active shooter protocol. As a result of a tremendous effort by our officers, every child was accounted for, no injuries to children. As a result of the tremendous leadership of the school employees and the teachers, all of the teachers were also located. We believe now that the building is completely empty. The officers will continue to search for this fourth suspect, and that's about all we have at this time concerning those things. And I'll answer a couple questions.
Are you urging business owners or residents in this area, being that he wasn't found in the school, that he could be in the area by a business or by a home?
We want to continue to ask the community to be vigilant if they see suspicious people and call us. You know, this is another example of the changing New Orleans Police Department. The call came out almost instantly. Officers were on the scene, and they made a very good decision here today to do the things that they did. So if anyone knows anything about this, you know, all call us, Crime Stoppers, 822-1111. Help us find who this fourth guy is who we want to get a hold of and talk to.
How long before you think you can be 100% sure that he's not in the school?
As soon as the canine finishes the search of the building, it's about halfway done, but I'm very confident that our SWAT officers who are specifically trained in clearing buildings have gone through the entire building. The school system gave us a blueprint so we knew where we were going and what we were doing. We also had master keys so that there's no door that we did not go into and check.
Are the other three men in custody cooperating? Any idea who this fourth person might be at this point?
At this point, those three people are being interrogated, interviewed, and I really can't say any more about that.
A tense situation, Chief, for parents. Not something any parent wants to see or hear on TV, that their child's school is in lockdown.
Right. And I want to thank you and the media for helping us get out messages timely and quickly that the children were okay, that we had them at St. Leo, the great school, and we were going to turn them over. John White, the former school superintendent, and John Dobard, the current superintendent, came to the scene immediately. We worked very closely with the school district to identify children, identify employees, and make sure that we knew where everybody was. What is important is that it is an incredibly tense moment for the families and a tense moment for the community, but our cops acted exactly the way they're supposed to act. They maintained their composure, they maintain their control and command of themselves and their situation, and I am incredibly grateful for the work they did out here today.
Chief, what do you think of this will do to the psyche of the community? You're already battling a serious violent crime problem, and now you have this incident near two schools.
We have Dr. Karen DeSalvo, the health commissioner, out here with us, and they will be accessing those resources overnight and into tomorrow to talk to the kids and to talk to anybody in the neighborhood. Look, these things happen, but when they happen, what you hope is going to be the case is that a well-trained police department is going to do exactly what it was supposed to do. A well-trained school staff did exactly what it was supposed to do.
If you could talk about the kids that got...
I'm confident there was no kids or no... gunmen inside the school. I know a couple of young kids that they saw the gunman outside the school, but no gunmen inside the school.
There were a total of four people we were looking for, and what a child saw could certainly have been true. We wanted to make sure that there was nobody in there, especially since we didn't know what happened to the fourth one after the three people were apprehended. Again, the officers made a perfect decision to take this on as an active shooter situation and lock the school down and protect the children.